Hi, I'm Wayne Cousins.
And I'm Ramona Marr.
This week on World Stage 86, the rides at Expo. And we're sitting in one right now. This is the Scream Machine, and we're going to be taking a ride on it in a few minutes.
Correction, you're going to be taking a ride on it in a few minutes. Also on this show, we'll preview Steam Expo, an incredible gathering of steam locomotives from the past.
And we'll have another edition of Expo Guide and the rides.
We'll get to the rides, but first, to the Telecom Pavilion to see a movie that literally surrounds you with action.
An avalanche in the Canadian Rockies. Just one of many exciting scenes in a movie called Portraits of Canada. The film will be the main attraction at Expo's Telecom Pavilion. It was shot in Circle Vision, a spectacular Walt Disney process that completely surrounds the viewer with action and sound. The people and places of Canada will be seen from a unique perspective. The day we visited the Telecom Pavilion, they were running tests on the projection equipment. There are 9 projectors in all, each with its own elaborate loop system to avoid rewinding the film after each 20-minute screening. The test film was a Walt Disney production about China. It will fill the gap until Portraits of Canada is completed a few weeks from now.
This is our, what we call our theater in the round. In the theater which we'll be showing our Circle Vision 360-degree movie, which has been put together by Walt Disney Productions for us. Over, of course, around here we have the 9 screens and 9 projectors for it.
Now, the images that we see on these screens, is this back projected?
No, it isn't. It's a case of each one of the black lines you see, there is a projector about halfway up there, and that projector is projecting across the theater to the other side, the screen across the other side.
Portraits of Canada will take its audience to the far-flung corners of this country. If you've never watched an igloo being built, Circle Vision will give you that, plus the feeling of actually being inside the igloo.
As I walked in, I noticed these railings. What are they for?
Well, number one, it's a stand-up theater, and because it's 360 degrees, the idea is that you can turn around and see what's behind you as well as in front of you. The railings themselves are for you to lean against and hold on to, because there's a considerable motion at times in the theater. For instance, if you're on a helicopter ride, and if you're not holding on, you get the feeling of motion, and you're just allowed to fall over.
Portraits of Canada will document this country's vastness, its drama, its cultural diversity, and its time-honored customs. And what impression will it leave the audience with? Perhaps it's best summed up by Pete Clark of Walt Disney Productions.
Well, I think if you're Canadian, you'll go away saying, God, I'm proud to be a Canadian. I think if you're from a foreigner who is visiting Expo, I think you'll go away and say, hey, those Canadians are what I always thought they were. Just wonderful people, and the country's beautiful. So I think it's going to be a good impression for all.
There's a lot more to the Telecom Pavilion than the Circle Vision movie. After leaving the theater, visitors will be treated to a fascinating array of modern technology designed to be enjoyed by the whole family. But that will have to wait till our next visit. At the Telecom Pavilion, I'm Wayne Cousins.
Wayne, this is it. We're at the Scream Machine. You're going and I'm not.
I'm all set. Look, can I convince you one more time to come with me?
I don't think there's enough seats, really.
Are you sure?
Go ahead.
You're going to miss
good
it.
Time. No, don't worry about it. You can
I've been
tell
waiting
me
for this
later.
For weeks.
I know you have.
They tell me it's the safest ride. It
I'm
looks
sure it
great.
Is. Take care, Wayne. Have a good ride.
For World Stage 86, see you when I get back. This is it. The Scream Machine. Perhaps the most thrilling ride at Expo 86. And I believe it. Ascending up this ramp, it feels like you're on top of the world. But right now, I'm not too concerned about the view. Starting off, a 360-degree loop. Coming out of that is a spiral and into the big corkscrew. Over and over twice. My God. I'm ready for it. So stay with us for the most exciting ride you're going to see at Expo 86. great, but that's the last thing on my mind. Here we go. This is it. The Scream Machine. Just a bit of a slow pace right now. And here we go. 360 degrees. All the way over. Yeah! Coming out of that's the spiral. We're gonna flip out again. And over on this side. 55 miles an hour. I can't believe it. We'll slow down here for a bit. And coming into the corkscrew, this is the one they say is gonna make or break. This is without a doubt the best ride I've ever been on. You might look intimidating from the ground, but wait till you get on it. It's better than I expected. Ramona, I made it. That was great.
Welcome back. I take it you liked it.
That is the best ride I've ever been on. It is just unbelievable, Ramona.
How do you feel?
Oh, the 360s, the loops, the turn, and the corkscrew was something else. I'm telling you, I've never been on a ride like that.
Well, if you could describe it in one word, what would you say?
Exhilarating.
Still ahead on World Stage, Expo Accommodation, a preview of Steam Expo, and more rides.
Grantree's fabulous 99 cent sale. You'll find hundreds of furniture bargains for less than a dollar. Like this gorgeous contemporary coffee table. Yours for only 99 cents with a purchase of Sealy's Sofa and Love Seat Suite or two-piece sectional. Both sets are on sale now for an incredibly low $788 or $47 a month. Buy one today and the coffee table's yours for only 99 cents. When it comes to buying...
The 1,000 acres of forest at the west end of the town site of Granville had been set aside by the federal government as a military preserve. That was in case the Americans invaded. Lord Stanley had it declared a park, and he wanted it to the use and enjoyment of people of all colors, creeds, and customs for all time. I couldn't have said it better myself.
And now, Expo Guide. Where do we stay when we come to Expo? That's an important question for many people coming to the fair from all over the world and all around Canada. If you need some answers, here they are. There are many options when it comes to accommodation. Hotels and motels are available in all classes, from deluxe to budget. Then there are campgrounds, trailer parks, resorts, hostels, and bed and breakfast services. Of course, you can expect all the rates to be somewhat higher than a normal summer, but that's usually the case in any city during special events. To make it as simple as possible for you to book the lodgings you or your visitors will need, a central reservation system has been set up. It's called Res West, and here's the address. Res West, Box 1138, Vancouver, BC, V6C2T1. A $5 booking fee is charged for each reservation made. You can also make your reservations by phone at this number, 604-662-3300. 604-662-3300. If you prefer, you can book your reservation directly through your hotel or through your favorite travel agent. Most agents are offering packages which combine hotel, expo tickets, and other sightseeing. The demand for accommodation is expected to be heavy, but remember that even if the more central locations are booked out, you might consider trying the outer areas of Vancouver and using the SkyTrain or the bus system to get to the expo site. However, if the regular accommodation does get fully booked, there's a backup system. It's the Host the World program. Homeowners in Greater Vancouver are being asked to make available rooms in their homes for expo visitors. If you'd like to be part of the program, or if you just want further information, call 660-EXPO, 660-EXPO. For people coming to Vancouver by private boat, there's a reservation service available for marinas in the area. There's a $10 fee for each booking. For further information, call this number, 604-687-SHIP, 604-687-SHIP. Now, if you missed any of the information I've been giving you, we'd be happy to send you a copy. Write to us at this address. World Stage 86, CBC Television, P.O. Box 4600, Vancouver, B.C., V6B4A2. And don't forget to include your home address. And that's Expo Guide.
Our guest this week on My Vancouver has won great acclaim in the field of modern dance. She's not a native Vancouverite, but now she wouldn't live anywhere else. She's well-known choreographer, Anna Wyman.
Line. Really establish that line. Okay, and nice and tall, but nice and long again, okay?
I came here to Vancouver in 1967, and I thought, I'm going to see Indians running all over the place and on their horses and you know, women walking around with long dresses. Of course, nothing like that was here, but I remember once walking down at Lonsdale, and and it was, in fact, with my daughter, and we saw about four women walking in the front, and they had those little hats on and long dresses, and I said, Gabby, look at this, here they are. You know, the Canadians, and we ran after them, and I wanted to say hi. I was so excited. And they walked into Safeway. And so I said, well, let's go into Safeway. And we walked in, and it was so disappointing because on each counter, one of those persons stood. And I said, what's going on, do you think? And it was centennial year.
A little bit late. Hush.
I like Vancouver. I like Canada. It is tough at times because, especially in Vancouver, you're very limited with art galleries. There are a lot of little galleries. We have a big gallery, which is wonderful. But you can't really get lost, like in Vienna, which is my home. Or in Paris or in Rome, you can go for weeks on end and see different things. So I need that as a choreographer. I need that kind of stimulation. I like the open space. I love the open space. I love the mountains. So I like pampering myself, basically. You know, I feel this is a very selfish attitude, probably, but I feel I'm number one, and I have to be number one in order to work with other people and feed other people. And I think the environment is helping me because basically I enjoy the Vancouver environment.
Nice feeling around, not so many steps. Up, down, and that's better.
Among all the transportation events during Expo this summer is one that's sure to bring out the little boy in a lot of grown men. Here's Cam Cathcart.
Each summer, the romance and nostalgia of steam is replayed for visitors as the Royal Hudson makes its way along the shore of Howe Sound. Standing still for now, BC's best-known steam engine is undergoing an annual refit before the new tourist season and expo begins in May. Built 46 years ago for the CPR and now owned by the provincial government, the Hudson earned its royal title after earlier sister engines pulled the royal train across Canada in 1939. At Steam Expo, starting on May 23rd, the Royal Hudson will be host to nearly 30 steam locomotives on display and powered up for train buffs.
As a little boy, I was reminded that my grandfather was a locomotive engineer, so I daydreamed of one day sitting at the engineer's window, my hand on the throttle, and watching the track ahead. Well, this is the closest I've come to that experience, but at least I can daydream.
One of those preparing to visit Vancouver is the famous Daylight of the Southern Pacific Railroad, now owned and operated by the City of Portland. Equally impressive will be the arrival of Union Pacific's Northern and Challenger locomotives, the largest to visit the West Coast. Also coming is the CNR's famous mountain-type locomotive, CN6060, now operating in Alberta. Chief organizer of Steam Expo is David Gibson. He says watching the journey of the big locomotives through BC on their way to Vancouver will be a special treat.
People in British Columbia, from Cranbrook up to Golden, through the Rogers Pass to Revelstoke, down the Thompson Valley to Kamloops, and down the Fraser Canyon to Vancouver, are going to have a real treat in the 4 or 5 days before May 23rd, as they get to see something very unusual go through their towns. And I expect that a lot of school groups will be turned out alongside the trackage to have a look at it. It's unusual, it's exciting, and it's romantic.
Canadian National has donated about 4,600 meters of yard trackage, a block and a half east of the Expo main entrance along Terminal Avenue. Amid the modern symbols and artificial intelligence of Expo 86, Steam Expo will be a reminder of the locomotive's place in the history of Western Canada.
Still to come on World Stage, a ride to the top of the Observatron, and one more spin on the screen machine.
Online, helping people to succeed.
Ever wonder why the Carroll and Cordova area of Vancouver is called the Skid Road? Because that's how it began. When the loggers would chop down the huge trees that covered Vancouver, the logs were pulled along a skid road made by embedding alder or maple logs for the big firs to skid along. They were pulled by great teams of oxen, then by teams of Clydesdale horses. At the mills, the steam engines took over. Don't say Skid Row to a Vancouverite. He'll tell you sharply, it's the Skid Road.
Machine is a real thriller, but what you see behind me is a much gentler thrill. Earlier today, Wayne and I took a ride on the Observatron. It was foggy, but you'll get the idea.
Here you are. Thanks.
This is what we call the Observatron, is what we're in right now, which is the cabin. It'll house up to 70 people, and it'll elevate to a height of approximately 220 feet very slowly. And it will descend very slowly and rotate. You get a good aerial view of the site and the surrounding beautiful city of Vancouver. The second element of the ride is called the space drop. And what it is a small capsule. We have two people in a capsule. Again, it arises to a height of approximately 220 feet and then gives you a simulated free fall at about 12 meters per second. And for about the last 40 feet, it's a controlled, or it is controlled through the whole drop, but it gives you the simulated free fall, and you're just may or may not want to take that if you're weak at heart.
Almost like floating in outer space for a while, is it?
I would say similar to if you step off a building and fall for a distance, yes.
Now, we went on the screen machine earlier. Apart from that and this, what other rides are on site?
We've got a flume ride, or what we're calling is a caribou log chute, which is directly to the northeast of us here. And that is where people get in a simulated log, and it's a fiberglass boat, and it takes you to a height of 15 meters, down a chute, back up and around through another height of 13 meters. And it's a very family-oriented ride, but it's thrill, wet, exciting. We also have a ride we call the Looping Starship, which is done in the theme of the space shuttle. It'll take a total of 54 people and throw them completely upside down a number of times.
So there are rides for every age group here?
Oh, there is. And for young and old, we have one which is the 1907 Philadelphia Toboggan Carousel. And anyone from baby till 150 years old could ride that, because it's a ride everyone would like to be on, very slow, smooth operating.
What do you think is the most exciting ride here?
The most exciting ride, I would say, would be the Scream Machine. The roller coaster is, people know that.
Keith, that was a fabulous ride. I felt like I was going about 100 miles an hour through some of those turns. But give us the real facts and figures on the Scream Machine.
The speed you were going at was probably somewhere between 50 to 55 miles an hour. Once the weather gets warmer, once the track gets taken care of with any small minor bumps that we have to alter, and once the actual trains get worn in, we'll probably get closer to around 60 miles an hour.
Is each train motorized?
No, once you get to the top of the lift of the 115 feet, it's gravity that takes you from that point on. You're lifted up with a chain all the way to that height, and then from there on, it's just gravity and nothing else, no hold barred.
Well, have you had enough thrills for the day?
I can never get enough of that ride. And in a couple weeks, I'm going to take you on a ride.
Oh, no.
You're going to love it. It's called the Looping Starship.
No, I'm a self-confessed wimp, remember? Next week on World Stage 86, a ride of a different kind. The fabulous Concorde, the world's most famous airplane, is coming to Vancouver during Expo, and we'll give you a preview.
And we'll preview the dynamic CN Pavilion, a hands-on experience that everyone's sure to enjoy.
We'll show you the giant mural on the walls of the UN Pavilion. It's fascinating.
All those stories and a couple more surprises, too, next week on World Stage. And right now, I'm off for another ride on the Scream Machine.
You're on your own, partner. For World Stage 86, I'm Ramona Marr, and he's Daredevil Wayne Cousins. See you next week.
Cousins again. We'd just like to say thanks to Keith Robertson and all the guys at Expo who helped us shoot the Scream Machine, especially Paul Harkins and Derek Brown, and the big boss, Chris Reaney. Thanks, guys. It was a lot of fun.